budgets, bound copies of the budgets.
It's just like reading, you haven't had anything to do.
Thank you very much.
That was really good.
I do know that I got up to.
Tell us how you want this.
And heard the horns out there still going, the people yelling.
I've never seen Washington do that much.
That the people don't have a kind of city feeling because it's the capital. They don't quite have that hometown feeling.
And frankly, this is the first time that the Washington's had it.
Any sample.
I think they have thirsted for something to be proud of. Something that will give them a sense of self-identity and respect. And I really think it may be more significant here than most places. There was no question. More representation.
A
lot of people got on buses and things and went out there hoping that somebody else would get a ticket for them. Left one of their party to stand in line all night long for the ticket window.
We ought to get started since we really only have a few minutes before we're supposed to go over to the last side.
Sit down and I don't know what to say, but I'm making you listen to something you can listen to again over there. But I think we all know the importance of this, and as I said about, I said to you, Tip, on the Social Security thing, I think it had a marked impact on the people out there. Seeing us working together, and I hope that we can. Whole discussion of this the same way, because I think it will again reassure the people at a time when they need some reassurance.
President, I get something like to talk to you.
Right.
You know, every time you go on the radio, you always talk about make work jobs. When I'm home on a winter vacation, I assign my staff to find out the emergency work that has to be done. So go to GSA and say if there was 100% employment in America, how much money would you need for emergency jobs? They said $3 billion. Why would you need $3 billion? Because of roofs, because of gutters, because the buildings need to be appointed, because of the fact that you have to weatherize the buildings, or straighten out the solid so there's no leaks. They went $3 billion. They went to every department. They went to Veterans Hospital. Veterans Hospital said $500 million that they need for the same reason, appointing the buildings. The buildings that deteriorate. If you don't do this work, what does it cost you down the line? Within a period of 5 years, you double what it costs you. You have out there, you put together a very reasonable bill. Each time I have to go and say, if unemployment was 100%, what would you need for emergency work? And you keep saying, these are make-work jobs. These are jobs, Mr. Speaker, that are going to cost the federal government more money if we don't do them now. Your budget does nothing for unemployment, and I think we've got the movement. When half of your deficit is because of the unemployment, now we're in the room here. I just want to express my viewpoints on it. Yeah, each time we talk about this, you talk about make-work jobs. I'm not talking about make-work jobs. I'm talking about emergency work that the president, that this government needs. Yeah, because if you don't do it, it's going to cost you more money down the road.
Well, if we... We've done this. Listen, if you don't fix the bridges.
If you don't fix the gutter of your own house, the roof goes on. And that's what I'm talking about.
But the only other thing that I think at a time like this.
Thank you.
citizens with this issue in Lebanon so that we can proceed with the business of overall peace. And I'd like you to know that my view is that the greatest security for Israel, with their economic situation reflecting that our camp status on 30% inflation and so forth. So we believe, maybe there's been some misunderstanding about what we're trying to do, we believe that the only way that could come about is if we have been able to persuade the Arab states that that must be the outcome for their own good as well. And we've made great headway. And right now, the difficulty is that with the new government in Lebanon trying to get itself established.
You indicate you might have a new flexibility on the third year of the tax cut. Is he right?
I can't take any questions here in this photo opportunity, but I think I've made some statements in the last couple of days that answer that. Ladies and gentlemen, this group here, I'm more than honored to have them here. These are Afghanistan freedom fighters. What they have undergone should be known by everyone in the free world. And they were tortured for 4 months. One of these men's wives killed in front of our two children. Another lost his brother in a massacre that took place. One was mayor of the village where the massacre took place. 105 people killed in a tunnel, burned and killed with chemicals. Fire, all of it. They simply hear the rain from behind the curtain of silence. Some of that's going on.
Lights, please.
I'm going to repeat what I told the other group here, how honored I am by these visitors that we had with the six from the Afghanistan freedom fighters. One lady underwent torture for 4 months while being held by the Soviets. There was a man here whose wife was killed in front of their two children. Another one who lost his brother in the tunnel, a village in which 105 people were massacred by fire and chemicals. One of them lost a brother. One is the mayor of that village where that took place. Another is the former justice of the Supreme Court in Afghanistan. They're here to try and tell the outside world, the free world, what's really going on in Afghanistan.
Mr. President, with Soviet behavior like that in Afghanistan,
you know,
as I hear, has not only had his wife executed by firing
squad lost two little children and forced to watch this. But he himself bears on his arm the proof of chemical warfare. He suffered from his heart through a chemical attack that he has survived. He's been seen by the first army once.
Many remarkable stories to tell, and they sound as though they come from another age, just because
genocide. Simply because I was able to collect these people from very different parts of the country and walk in on horseback, and there was no possibility of communication between them. And we actually went into the tunnel and found that, true enough, exactly what they described had indeed taken place. Now, this seems to be a policy not just applied in one place to terrify people, but actually to terrify people all over the country. At one point, we rode through 12 villages, one after the other, in the desert.
Clarify one thing for me. That massacre, I'd been informed first that it was, I guess it was probably because it was ghastly, that they were gassed in the tunnel, But you say now, no, they were burned.
Yes, that was a misunderstanding because of the fact that the priest here, we got there on the second day after the massacre, he was the first one to bring him to Pakistan. He said they were bringing gas masks. That's what he told me. Bringing gas masks instead of oxygen.
Finished burning these people, they applauded. The soldiers actually applauded, and then they packed up their gear and left. People were just horrified. Bodies were burned beyond recognition. There were 11 children in there, of age 6, 8, 11, ages like that. It's a very cruel war, Mr. President. They don't make any presence.
Now, about how deep would that water have been in the tunnel? I mean, I assume the people could wade in the water.
Ankle deep.
Oh, just ankle deep.
We went in there. Yeah. We got into that village a month later. And I suppose this is, I don't think the Soviets ever believed that anybody would dare go so near to a Soviet fort and try to find out evidence on the ground. And I'm glad we did it, but it's the strange thing about this war that it was modern warfare with some chemicals added to gasoline, fortress over there, helicopters in the sky. The way we could run away from that was on horses. It's the 15th century, it's the 20th, and it's a very cruel 20th century. Conceive of giving up. We can't even think of it because they want to kill us all. That's what the concentration camp commander east of Kabul said once. And this is something the Soviets admitted in Yekaterinburg. Concentration camp commander said, "We're only going to leave 1 million Afghans alive. That's all we need to build socialism." And the Soviets have admitted this. I got that story out, attacking me and a liar and so forth. But having said that, well, he was executed because he shouldn't have said things like that. Of course, that was all telling you. The means of all, not a present life's fault. But the story, you can bring this up.
Anyway, if you will.
I can start to go fight on this present. Go fight on this present. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you. I'm pleased to have that.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President.
should be. She should be. She should be. She should be. She should be.